What's going on, guys? So we are gonna try to get this thing started. So the goal is drain the oil, put the rear part of the exhaust on, install the steering rack, do the water pump, put in the radiator. That should be it to get it started. Yeah. Okay, so let's start draining the oil. All right, guys, so oil's changed. I put 5 quarts in it for now. And I got that exhaust is sitting on there. Obviously, it's not where it's gonna be, but I need it on, oh God, with the O2 sensors ran, which they're ran. I'll still have to zip tie them up, the wiring. And so that's going. Next is to, put in the steering rack and then get that hooked up. Then once the steering rack's hooked up, we could probably drop it down on the wheels and do the rest of the stuff just so it's easier. Yeah. So let's get the steering rack in. The water pump's not on yet. I got the radiator in, put this on, did the steering rack. So, just 1 second. So I have it running just off the headers, and well, it's headers to the X pipe for the other two O2 sensors. The check engine light's not on, which is awesome. But she's a freaking monster, and I can't wait to get this thing done and let her eat. All right, guys, so we got it started. Now we just need to do the water pump, the fans, run the rest of the coolant lines, hook them all up. I'm going to hook up the rest of the exhaust. I want to get this whole thing 100% put together before we start doing the torque converter. I want to make sure it's okay before we do the torque converter, because I don't want to have a problem in the front end down the road and have a problem with the torque converter. If something goes wrong with that, I just want one thing at a time. So, yeah. So I'm gonna push this thing back in the garage and get cracking on the rest of it. All right, guys. So now that you saw it running, we need to start finishing the car. So I wanna get the water pump put on and these 10 mil bolts all get torqued to go around at 11 foot-pounds and then go back around at 22 foot-pounds. So once I get the water pump on, I'm probably gonna start taking off everything for the intake manifold so I can get to that and get the oil pressure sensor replaced, which is in the back, new gaskets on the intake manifold, this little flat plate down there, replace that gasket, get that all cleaned up, and remove the air pump, the rest of the air pump system that's back there. And then it's throwing it all back together. putting the belt on, putting the fans on, radiator hoses, and then the rest of the stuff. I might actually wait to do the water pump till after I do the intake manifold, because it just might be in the way and it just might be easier just not have it there, and it'll allow me to clean that stuff up a little bit better. This whole thing's going to get power washed once I'm done. I really want to get this thing nice and clean and spotless for the owner. So yeah, we're gonna start taking off the intake manifold. All right guys, so we got the intake manifold off, and we got this, I can't remember what this plate's called, but the two knock sensors sit in there. So one thing that I had a trouble figuring out, so these are a newer style knock sensor. The older style ones just have a clip. These ones actually have this fitting, and you just get in there with needle nose pliers and squeeze these fatter sides, and they pop right off. So we're going to go ahead and we put new seals here for the knock sensors, new gasket, cleaned everything up, and we're going to go ahead and install that plate back on. We also put a new oil pressure sensor in, and that is it. Oh, and then we removed that line for the air pump. So I'm going to go ahead and get this plate back on, get this intake manifold back on, and then fire it up and make sure that the oil pressure sensor actually is fixed. So let's get that all back together. Intake manifold and everything back on, I'm gonna go ahead and put on the rear part of the exhaust. I'm just gonna kind of kind of put it on. I'm not going to fully do it and make sure it's perfect. It's just going to throw it on. And then I'm going to start working on everything up front. And then I actually want to put this outside. I got LEDs for the interior of the Beamer, and I want to put those in. So let's get working. All right, guys. So she's all together. The only thing I need to do now is bleed the coolant. And that's pretty much going to be it for now. Oh, you know what? Forgot to put these bad bitties on. I don't know if I can. Yeah, I think these need a little bracket piece. All right, guys. So she's all back together. I have the filter off right now because I'm doing some testing. It's weird. Like, after I put everything back together, like, I had it kind of like this without the shrouds and stuff on. And it would start up fine. I didn't have the rear part of the exhaust on, and it would start up fine and idle and no issues. Then, while I was doing some of the hoses and stuff, I forgot to plug this back in before I went to start it. And then ever since then, this thing has been a nightmare. So I have the battery disconnected. I'm letting it disconnect it till probably tomorrow or the next day, and hoping it clears itself and it'll run. If not, hopefully the company that's tuning it can figure it out. But yeah, so she's back together, no leaks, which is awesome. But that's gonna be a wrap for this one. The next one will probably be doing the torque converter. Don't know when I'm gonna start that. Maybe Monday. Today's Friday. So we'll see, but I appreciate you guys watching, and I'll talk to you later.